everyone here and welcome to my channel Graphic Review. Today I'm going to show you how to create a plane like this in After Effects using Trap Code Particle plugin. And okay, let's go. First I'll create a new composition and I'll make it Full HD, frame rate 30 and duration 10 seconds, and then hit OK, go to File and import your OBJ file, drag and drop, and I'll close it like this. Now I'll go to layer, no solid, not light, I want solid, and I'll name it particles or particle. Then hit OK. I'll go to effect, trap code, and particular. And come on, yeah, here you go. This is very good. So I'll go to emitter, point, emitter type, point, set point to, for sure, OBJ model. Okay, you can choose from particular, and I'll do it, I'll leave the tutorial into the description. And in this time, no, I'll take another from outside of OBJ emitter. So now I'll take plain OBJ and I'll make all velocity here to 0. And see, this is our plane. Okay, and I'll change particles per second to, I'll add two zeros. Then I'll go to layer and I'll add a new camera. Okay, again I'll go to particle and so first let me go to camera and I'll take track Z to make it bigger to see this. Okay, yeah, now press C to change camera target and press just C. Okay, to change. Okay, now I'll go to particle again. Let me close. I'll make it edges, yeah. And loop, okay. Everything here is good. So let me close emitter and I'll go to particle. And I'll change size to 0.5. This will be good. And see, yeah. First, let me go to emitter to see what's the difference between emit from edges and faces, or I think edges. Yeah. Okay. So let me also change size random to maybe something like 30 or around 30. Also opacity random around 30. And I'll open size overlay presets and I'll choose the second one. Let me try this. Yeah, this one. Okay, now I'll go to opacity over life. Also I'll choose this and at start color set color, I'll take over life and open color over life presets and I'll choose this blue color. Also if you want to change this, I'll take the blue one like this. It's good for me. Okay. And so let me close particle, and now I'll go to physics. Okay, air and turbulence field. I'll increase effect size a little bit, something like 2. Okay, and also complexity, I'll change it to, or sorry, scale. Let me increase scale. Okay, so this is our beautiful plane. Okay. Okay, now I'll go to effect, stylize, and I'll add a glow. And let me change intensity, decrease it, and I'll increase radius, also threshold, let me increase it also, maybe 85, yeah. And I'll go to fix some presets, and I'll add, if you have it, okay, deep glow, deep glow, double click or drag and drop, okay, and I'll change radius for sure, 100, also, yeah, something, yes, this is very good. Okay, now I'll add a new adjustment layer because I want to add. I'll go to effect, color correction, and I'll go to curves. I want to add a curve, RGB curve here and here. I don't know if you add glow to be good. Aha, it's scary, but with me, increase radius, I don't know, yeah, not bad. Okay, so now I'll go to, let me go to particle and move this line, drag it inside like this. Okay, okay, now I'll go to camera, right click, and hey, come on, right click, yeah, I'll create camera, and I'll create object null. Okay, and I'll press P for position and shift R for rotation. So let me see position to move this plane. Now orientation Y, and this is Z up, something like this. Okay, this is very good. And now let me go to Z. Make sure that you are on the first frame, keyframe on position, few seconds forward, and yeah, move your plane. You are the captain now. Okay, change it to water just right now to see this. Okay. Also, we can add some rotation for this plane. So I'll go to first frame, orientation keyframe, and okay, something like this, and also Z position, and also one. Okay. Yeah. Oh, I think this is good. So now I'll take let me take particle and adjustment, shift adjustment layer, camera and null, right click and pre-compose all. Okay, so yeah, now I'll go to layer and I'll add a new solid and I'll name it particle as a background, then hit OK, go to effect, trap code, or let me delete this. Okay, so I'll go to delete this and I'll go to particle here, control D to copy, and I'll go to emitter and set point, set the OBJ model to box. Okay, and now I'll go to this particle, control X, okay, to cut. Hey, come on. And I'll go to composition and control V to put it here. So now we have a box particle like this. So I'll change XYZ length to individual and increase XY. Okay. And also I'll change this particle to just 500. Then I'll go to particle and size, I'll change size to 1 or 2. Yeah, this is very good. Okay, now we have a glow and deep glow also. Okay, this is very good. Now I'll add a new background solid as a background. I'll put it down, then I'll go to effect, generate, and okay, let me choose, where are you, gradient ramp. Okay, and change linear to radial and put this point in the middle and change the white color to blue. Okay, something like this. Blue and black, I'll choose another blue. Okay, or maybe let me add a color. Okay, this color will be good. Okay, yeah, or maybe, yeah, this, yeah, this is good. Okay, so now I'll import a cloud, drag and drop, and press S to scale it up like this, and I'll go to effect to remove this. Let me change it to screen and see what's going on. Oh, not bad. Okay, so I'll add effect and color correction tint, and I'll change the white color something like this, good for me, and Let me put it down. Okay, after background, and I press T for opacity. Okay, and I'll add, press P for position. Go to first frame also. If this plane move from right to left, so let me change this cloud to move from left to right. Okay, so position few frames or few seconds frame, and I'll move our cloud to a realistic animation line. Okay, this is our tutorial today, so if you like it, don't forget like, share, subscribe, and goodbye.